But here, whether Jews or Greek, it means that Jews, we have one sitting with us. What does it mean in that passage here? It means that the Jews and the Greeks, whether slave or free, are also baptized whenever they baptized by the Spirit at salvation. Does she still hold her nationality? Yes. It doesn't change her passport in the purse. Divide your word sharply. The distinctions are not fully erased. It simply says and teach that not all distinctions are erased. Here, the teaching is that entrance into the body is true of all, even an Arab person.
Yeah.
If I would have an Arabic person here, a descendant of Ishmael, is still a descendant of Ishmael, a Muslim family converting to our beautiful faith. You cannot say to him, give me your passport, we'll give you a Gentile passport. That does not erase his nationality. Mm-hmm. When does it occur? This is my next question. We're coming close to the end. Actually, very close. When does it happen? Simultaneously to my salvation or subsequently? The answer is simultaneously. Oh, but I never felt goosebumps. Doesn't matter. And if you feel good bumps, praise the Lord for you. The day that you are saved, for myself, it was almost 30 years ago now, 20-some, 1980, 1993, December. The day that I was saved, I cried. I don't remember having had goosebumps. Cried for a full night, full night. I was saved, and I was also, therefore, placed into the body of the Messiah by means of Spirit baptism. By means of Spirit baptism. How about the frequency? Do you know what I mean by frequency? How often does it happen, the frequency of it?
Salvation?
Only once?
Yeah, no, once and repeated. I'm giving you the detail, both. Okay? It occurs only once for a person, because you cannot be saved and resaved. Okay, so it cannot be repeated for you, Sally. It cannot. It's a one-shot deal. But every single time on this planet that a person comes to faith, it's repeated.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
Need to have the proper terminology. So you cannot receive the Holy Spirit 10 months after your salvation, unless you were not truly saved 10 months ago. Uh-huh. But once you're found, because this is your membership, not a paper membership, that's what unites you with the Messiah. It's not the water baptism. The water baptism is simply a means of identification of something spiritual. It's an outward act of something inward. The water does not save.
Oh, yeah.
But Spirit baptism does, because it is subsequent to, it is simultaneous to salvation. I conclude. Three results of Spirit baptism. I'm done. Three things that I need to say. It unites all the believers by membership into the body of Christ. 1 Corinthians 12:13, you're right there. It unites us in Christ, into his body, the church. That's why you are all members of it. And I'm not going to let you go without explaining the gifts down the road, because I need you. You need to exercise your gift, beloved. Mm-hmm. Number two, it unites the believers with Yeshua. In what way?
Spirit.
How many of you did the position in Christ? It unites the believer with Yeshua in the fact that you have been crucified, co-buried, and co-resurrected. So now you are united with Christ by means of Spirit baptism. Mm-hmm. You are identified with him, with the three co-co-co. Co-death, co-crucified, co-buried, and co-resurrected, as far as this sin nature is concerned. You retain it. Here, you take my sport jacket, you two people, and you write sin nature. and I put it back because I need to, because I retain it. It's not eradicated at salvation. So I put it back. You have my regenerated nature, and I still have the sin nature. What happened at the crucifixion? It's that sport jacket. I don't need to obey that when it talks to me. It's dead. It was nailed to the cross. Meaning, François, you're no longer a slave of it. Now you can, by the Holy Spirit, obey me. You don't have to obey this. So every time that I do something in the flesh, I obey that. But I, when I operate by the Spirit, I obey my newly regenerated spirit. And that's why we need to get sanctified together in the Word. You're not going to get sanctified with the days of Elijah music. Going to get confused. Music is good. Electric guitar and the little drum. I like it myself. But the way, the means, a person, a body can get sanctified and grow, it's by the opening of the Word of God and walking in obedience to these things. Number three, four new relationships. You have a new identification in Christ. It's a new entity. Small a, number three, small a, new identification. Small b, new position. You're no longer of the world. He took you out of the world system here, and he said, okay, you are in the cosmos right now, going nowhere, and now I place you in my body. So you need to change the job. You need to change the priority. I'm not saying to quit your job. It's not what I'm saying. But now you have a new identification here, a new position, a new union with God and with others as well. Okay? You have a new union with God. You have a full access because you are in Christ. And God the Father cannot be approached apart from the means by which he wants to be approached. And if you want to have a relationship with the Father, you need to have the outfit of the Messiah. Clothed with Christ. By the three cause, if you want to. The new association, how? No longer in Adam. Ah, this you will like. You're no longer in Adam, the perishable Adam, the Adam that died. The Adam was kicked out. That's the flesh. Now your new identification is in Christ, the new Adam. The immortal Adam. Because I know you have a driver's license. I know you have a passport. Have fun. Build yourself a spiritual passport. Based upon what was taught tonight. I'm done with this. Tonight, the emphasis was, beloved, I leave that with you, and I'm not going to ask you the question. I repeat only one thing. I'm not going to re-sermon you right now. Are you saved? I believe you are.
Yeah.
If you're not, you need to place your faith in Christ as your personal Savior, as a substitute that he died for you, was buried, and rose again. That's your substitution. Okay? If you are already saved, and I'm asking you the question, you can wait a bit, Olga. I'm right there anyway.
Sorry.
Have you been baptized in the Holy Spirit? Please give me the answer now. You can say it out loud.
Yes.
Yes, you have been. Don't let anybody tell you that if you don't speak in tongues, you have not. You have. That's the proper doctrine of the Scriptures. You have been baptized by the Holy Spirit. God bless you. What I would like to do right now is Olga will play a song. Don't sing. Just, I will criticize a bit. Play it, Olga. We'll play it twice. It's only 3 minutes. Look at the word. As long as we don't sing that to ask him to come, is in you. Mm-hmm. It resides in you. It's not a pizza. The Holy Spirit is not pizza. Come my lunchtime. So I'm not demeaning. I just want to make sure that we sing scripture. Come Holy Spirit, he has already come, he indwells you, he is everywhere, he is omnipresent.
Oh yeah.
So we don't need to say come. Let's enjoy the song anyway. Oh yeah. Because I like it.
Fall fresh on me.
Yeah, sure. Sure, why not?
Fill me with your power.
It's not spirit, that is a spirit filling. We are already filled.
Satisfy my need.
Why not?
Only you can make.
Which are you? You are already whole.
Give me strength to make me grow.
Spiritually, big time, big time.
Come Holy Spirit.
It's okay.
Fall afresh on me.
Why not? It's okay. I cannot criticize that. That's the text. Paraphrase or not paraphrase, I'm not arguing. Let all who take refuge in you rejoice. Let them sing for joy. Spread your protection over them. That those who love your name may exalt in you.
Only you can make me
sure.
Whole.
Yeah.
Give me strength to make.
Give me grace.
Grow.
It'll be better, but strength is perfect too.
Come Holy Spirit. Beloved, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with your spirit, Lord S, your spirit, your human spirit, brethren, and the people say,
Amen. Amen.
At this moment, at this very moment, the official meeting of the church is dismissed, so thank you so much for this. Let me make some announcements, okay? I wanted to play twice, but it's okay. I feel that it's perfect like this. Take your bulletin with you. If you don't have a bulletin, Terry has that. Where's Terry? Terry.
Sleeping.
Okay, Terry sleeping as usual. Okay. The Holy Spirit put him to sleep. So. October the 3rd, the Universal Church message for it's behind us. Okay. Next week, October the 10th, we will be in this Messianic congregation celebrating the Day of Atonement. The Day of Atonement, beloved, honestly, I can do 5 messages on that, I won't do it. So each year, when we will come across the Day of Atonement at the fall like this, I will give a different slant to it. That's what we call in Hebrew Yom Kippur, the Day of Atonement. So the emphasis of our celebration and meeting of prayer next week will be this. Don't come with a grumpy face, but it's not a day of rejoicing. So the song will be sadness and so on, in a sense. Just to get a little bit of a Jewish
flavor of these guys, what they do and what they celebrate in the synagogue, and how together we can pray for them. On October the 17th, now we come cheerful. That's the Feast of Tabernacle, and we'll explain the thousand-year kingdom. And I will always explain these festivals of Israel as they relate to the Messiah. You will be receiving a message of about 40, 45 minutes like today. As far as it goes to Christ, I will probably display a few booths, what was happening in Olga's backyard, what the kids do, and what they sing, and what they say, and what it does represent. And then, on October the 24th, Universal Church Message 5, I will carry on with this to show you how we reconcile Acts when the Spirit baptism began, and the Universal Church again on October 31st, so don't miss us. Turn around, I will show you something just quickly before we dismiss. I bought this, very, very simple, just in case you want to put your prayer request. It is a pen and small piece of prayer. You can always stop by, give them to Germaine when she's there, or me if you see my car, and we will elevate them. I don't think it's necessary, but I wanted to do it for those who like that kind of thing. You have noticed that here we don't pass the plate yet. Will we in the future, a plate of offering? I don't think I will, okay? The issue of giving in the church will be addressed here throughout the year, one number one and maybe the year number two. If you have in mind your 10%, it's completely off. It's not 10% at all. And I'm not going to call it the 10%, the tithes and offering. It's your donations by grace. So it's anywhere between 0 to 100% of your salary. It's anywhere from minus 10, because there might be a day for you to receive from these people. And there will be a day for you to bless these people in this congregation. What I can tell you, she needs to go back. We support, we have started already. We support Camp Shoshana in the United States, in New York. Okay, so portion of the money given goes to Camp Shoshana, because the gospel is to the Jewish people first, Romans chapter 1, verse 16. Us in Duncan, they're not very known. We have some in Victoria and Oak Bay. I'm not going to ask you to go evangelism in Oak Bay, but the ministry that we support is a direct organization that shares the gospel with the Jewish people in New York and all around the world. So automatically we fall under the umbrella of the Abrahamic covenant. I will bless those that bless you. Have a sensitivity to that. Olga, before you leave, what shall I say? Do I forget something? You can talk right now. You can talk to me.
Yeah,
you can ask questions. Not in the regular meeting, but now, yes. Am I omitting something?
Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. That's what we need.
Good stuff. We did every week. Donation.
God bless you, everybody.
She needs to go for the babysitter.
I have to go.
What else? Do you have any questions? The donation, the prayer box.
Look alive, people! It's over. You can stand. You can walk.
Like
you can do.
That's it. The prayer box. You can also put your input on that. If you are good with PowerPoint,
bye.
To match a PowerPoint to a song, we can buy a sound system that has a little bit more bass in it.
No.
She wants to
do
it.
I need volunteers or babysitter. I can do it myself.
She needs volunteer or babysitter. Anyway, if you have suggestion, I'm not going to say yes to everything. It does involve money all the time. We need to be careful with all this. Errol was asked to read the text. If you like to publicly read mail because of the proper decorum only in this instance here, ask me. Let me know. Occasionally, I'm going to ask Errol to read a passage type of thing, nice and loud. Get involved with me. Help me out. It spares my voice. You stand up, you read the text, and then we sit down and we carry on the proper way of doing things here, which I will elaborate daily on these things. You will be taught all kinds of stuff. We are dismissed already, so stand up, greet your people, go back home. You see, we keep it an hour, 15 an hour. It's beautiful. God bless you, and thank you for all things.
Do you get the feeling he's a
when you want to replace the old bird, twice a month, once a month,
CDs? Oh, okay. Does he do this on CDs?
Yeah.
Is it?
You trust me with that kind of stuff?
The basketball team, she kept on and on and on and on.
It's probably off. I think it's off that red dot there and something. I think it means.
Really? Yeah. Oh.
Are you in a rush to go home? I wouldn't like to go home. Everybody's got different heights, or
yeah,
and it only needs it in one.
No, no, I'm going to, but this is my oldest cat. This is Moxie.
Mm-hmm.
She's 16.
Oh, wow.
This is the one who's got cancer.
Oh.
She's only 13, and she's cool. Yeah.
But you know,
yeah.
They're at the age.
Yeah, I know. I know they're all going to go
you
soon.
You need to start over with kittens.
Oh.
Maybe kittens, maybe a dog, maybe nothing. Oh,
so I have to
clarify
this.
Oh,
in other
relations,
if you can go for a long journey, somebody that's safe.
Yes, I agree. Yeah. So they're friends.
No.
Exactly.
No. At the rapture.
Don't try to
at the
rapture. Okay, good. Yeah.
The tribulation saints, they will suffer martyrdom. That's why it's not time to join the church at all. They will be tremendously persecuted.
Okay.
Some won't die, but some will.
You still have to stay.
There is no rapture. They still have to go through the tribulation. Correct.
Okay.
Correct.
Oh, good. I'm glad I checked that.
Absolutely.
Because I've been telling people the truth. Okay.
Yes. But based on the message tonight, they are not baptized by the Holy Spirit. They are regenerated by the Holy Spirit, and they can be filled by, but not baptism. Because baptism is what places you in the body of Christ.
Yeah. Okay.
That's spirit baptism. That's it. You nailed it right now.
Oh, okay.
Okay?
Okay, so they do have to go.
That's it. Because the spirit baptism is exclusively for the church. From Acts 2 to today. That's it. The church will be gone, no more baptizing. You cannot say, I have the gift of teaching, I have the gift of this and that, because the gifts are given for the building up of the body of the church. Doesn't mean that you cannot be saved.
Yeah, you can still be
if
saved.
You, if you ask Job, did you receive the gift of the Spirit? Job will say, I don't know what you're talking about. And he was a believer. If you talk to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, what gift do you have in your church? They will say, I don't know what you're talking about. Correct. The body was not. Correct.
Good. Otherwise, I'd have to be on the phone.
God bless you. Thank you. Stephanie, when do you come and meet the baby at our place? You need to get. She needs to explain to you this. That's okay. So you can go whenever.
Saturday or Monday night, probably.
Saturday, we do nothing. I teach here. Go there with mom. Come and see our place, have coffee with us, because it's going to be enough for you to go around. Just to get to sit down on the carpet, to know her environment. We would like to do it before you get trashed into the work. If she has a pool, how do you wash her? You need to meet to see our environment. So why don't you come on this coming Saturday? I don't need to be there. Olga's there in the morning by herself. She would be delighted to show it to you. I'm here on Saturday morning. You don't come on Saturday morning.
Yeah.
It doesn't have to be this week, but we need to move it.
Okay.
We need to do it. Okay? Because I just want to make sure that you're at ease with the apartment, that you're confident there and so on, you know where she sleeps and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. In which bowl do you serve this? And you're always speaking all these things. No, you need to do it's perfectly normal. Before you get into the a little bit of the routine with this, you need to know what it's all about. Okay? Good stuff. Thank you so much. I'm going to go home now. I'm going to set up only tomorrow. Because people were chatting at the end, and if we unfold the table, it chases the people away.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you make noise, and you feel like, get out of
there.
That's it. Okay, God bless you, folks.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Thank you. Come soon, Steffi. Don't wait too long. the cable, the charger. I think it says it's at home.
Because I will probably need the charger, eh?
Yeah, but it's at home. I don't think I have the charger here. So this one should go in the box.
I'll leave it there.
Okay. There you go. You need to come home and get the charger. But at least it's at home because you don't need to come here for this.
It'll work. Bye, okay? Bye.
Okay, bye. Was it good?
Yeah, very good.
Bye, folks.
Thank you, Francois.
Are you most welcome, Brandon? Thank you.